Hi, I am Dr. Abhishek Joshi, and in this video lecture, we are going to discuss about the optical fiber waveguides, and in this, we are going to discuss about the phase velocity and the group velocity. And finally, we are going to discuss about the mode field diameter and the spot size. Now, let's discuss what is a phase velocity. So, phase velocity is given by, it is denoted by Vp. And the formula for phase velocity is given by omega by beta. So we know that omega is nothing but 2 pi f by beta. So we can write the frequency in terms of wavelength that is given by, or we can write the beta. We know that beta equals to n1 times of k, and the k, that is the wave number, it can be represented by 2 pi by lambda. So if you substitute the value of beta, that is n1 times of k, and that is equals to n1 times of 2 pi by lambda, we are getting 2 pi f divided by, and n1 times of 2 pi by lambda. So this 2 pi and 2 pi will cancel out, and we are getting, that is f by n1 times, and lambda will be multiplied. And we know that lambda into f is nothing but the speed of light, that is c by n. So this means the phase velocity of a light can be calculated as, that is Vp is equals to c by n1. So this will be the phase velocity of a wave. If we are talking about this wave varying with time, having amplitude, some amplitude A, so we are calculated the phase velocity. Now let's discuss what is the group velocity of a wave. So group velocity, that is Vg, is nothing but the differential change in the angular frequency divided by the constant, that is a phase constant, that is d beta. Now, how we can simplify? So, to understand it, we can consider that we are having the wave, multiple waves with slightly different frequency. So, if we want to calculate the group velocity, we can use this formula. If we want to further simplify it, we can simplify it as, that is Vg is nothing but d omega by d lambda and d lambda by d beta. To further simplify it, we have to differentiate the omega with respect to lambda, and then we can solve this, that is d beta by d lambda. So the same can be written as, that is d omega by d lambda multiply with d beta by d lambda inverse. So first we have to solve this term. So this is the first term. Then we will solve the second term. For solving the first term, we know that, that is omega is equals to 2 pi f. So solving first term, that is d omega by d lambda, that is equals to, that is d by d lambda, and omega equals to 2 pi f, and f we can represent in terms of the wavelength, that is c by lambda. So if you want to differentiate, we can take it as common, the 2 pi d by d lambda, and c also we can take common, this is a constant value, and we are having 1 by lambda. So what will be the differentiation? Differentiation is given by, this is c, that is speed of light, it is simplified as, so 1 by lambda differentiation is 1 by minus 1 will be multiplied and 1 by lambda square. So this will be the differentiation of d omega by d lambda. Now if we want to further simplify the second term, so we can write this as, because we know that that is 2 pi c by lambda is nothing but omega by lambda, or it can be written as minus omega by lambda. So this is the complete term for the first term, that is d omega by d lambda. Now further solving the second term, that is d beta by d lambda. D beta by d lambda we are solving, and we can solve it as, that is we know that beta is equals to n1 times of k. So we have, we can substitute d by d lambda, and beta is given by n1 times of k. Substituting the value of the k, that is the wave number, we are having, it is equals to 2 pi by lambda. So what we have is, that is d by d lambda, and it is given by n1 times 2 pi by lambda. So 2 pi is a constant, so we can take it outside. What is left is, that is d by d lambda, n1 by lambda. So we know the identity, that is for the differentiation, when we have d by dx of u by v, this can be solved as, if you use the differentiation identity, that is u by v, we can solve it as, that is v square and v d u by dx minus u dv by dx. Now here u is nothing but n1 and v is nothing but lambda. So substituting the value of n1 and lambda in this expression, what we'll get is, we are getting, that is d by d lambda, n1 by lambda. So here we are replacing, so we get lambda times d n1 by d lambda minus, here we have u means n1 times dv, v is lambda divided by d lambda. In the denominator, it is lambda square. So further simplifying it, what we'll get is, after the simplification or simplifying it further, this lambda square is simply divided, and what we get is, that is 1 by lambda d n1 by d lambda minus n1 by lambda square d lambda. So d lambda and d lambda differentiation will be simply 1. So we can simply write 1. So this is the differentiation of d by d lambda, n1 by lambda. So we'll get that is d beta by d lambda as what we have, that is 2 pi multiplied by the differentiation. So 2 pi, then the differentiation is 1 by lambda d n1 by d lambda minus n1 by lambda square system. Now, further substituting this in the expression, this is our second term and this is our first term. So, we have the first term. Substituting the first term and the second term in this expression of the group velocity, what we will get is, that is omega by d omega by d lambda can be written as, that is 2 pi c by lambda square. So, we have minus 2 pi c by minus 2 pi c by lambda square, and then it is multiplied with the second term. Second term is d beta by d lambda inverse. So, substituting it, we have 2 pi, then 1 by lambda d n1 by d lambda minus n1 by lambda square and inverse. So, from here, we can see that if you take this 2 pi outside, this 2 pi and 2 pi will cancel out, and what is left is, that is, further simplifying it, that is Vg, that is equals to minus C by lambda square, and what we have, 1 by lambda d n1 by d lambda minus n1 by lambda square inverse. So, if you multiply the entire term within the bracket, what we will get, that and taking this common, that is 1 by lambda common, what we have is, that is the group velocity is given by minus c by lambda square, and we are taking this 1 by lambda outside, so inverse, so it will be multiplied. And what is we are getting is d n1 by d lambda minus n1 by lambda inverse. So, here we can see we are having this lambda, and this lambda square will cancel out, and what is left is, that is, and we can multiply. So, further simplifying it, what we can write this expression, that is Vg as, and multiplying this minus 1 inside the bracket. So, we have C by lambda, that is equals to N1 by lambda minus D N1 by D lambda. So, again we can multiply this term inside, and here we have the inverse. So, we can write the same thing in the denominator. So, we are having, that is Vg equals to C by lambda times N1 by lambda minus D N1 by D lambda. And if it is multiplied inside, what we get is, that is N1 minus, or further finally it can be written as the final expression of the group velocity can be written as, that is C by N1 minus lambda times d n1 by d lambda. Now, the denominator term, this term is known as ng, that is the group index. So, we have seen that the group velocity can be calculated as the speed of light divided by the group index, that is c by ng. So, it can be written as c by ng. And the phase velocity is nothing but it is written by, that is C by or omega by lambda, or the phase velocity is given by C by n. So phase velocity is speed of light divided by the refractive index of the core, and the group velocity is given by C by the group index. Now let's discuss what is the mode field diameter and the spot size. So the mode field diameter, the transverse extent of the optical intensity distribution of a mode, is specified as the mode field diameter. Many properties of the fundamental mode are determined by the radial extents of its electromagnetic field. Mode field diameter is an important parameter for characterizing single mode fiber, and the properties which takes into account the wavelength dependent field, the penetration into the fiber cladding. Next is, for the step index fiber and the graded index fiber, when we are talking about the near parabolic profile, where we are having the alpha value of alpha, that is equals to 2, because in the previous lecture we have discussed that alpha determines which profile we have for the graded index. So single mode fiber operating near the cutoff frequency, that is lambda c. So we have the cutoff wavelength here. The field is well approximate by the Gaussian distribution. So in this case, the mode field diameter is generally taken as the distance between the opposite, that is 1 by e. So value of 1 by e is given by 0.37. The field amplitude point and the power. So power can be calculated as 1 by e square, that is 0.135, and the point in relation to the corresponding values on the fiber axis. Next is the important point, that is spot size. So what is spot size? It is nothing but the mode field radius. So the mode field diameter of a single mode fiber is the spot size or the mode field radius. So spot size is also known as the mode field radius, that is represented by omega naught. Hence the mode field diameter having the relation with the spot size, that is equals to twice of omega naught. And what is omega naught? Omega naught is the nominal half width of the input excitation. So the mode field diameter can therefore be regarded as the single mode analog of the fiber core diameter. So in a multimode fiber. So however, for many refractive index profiles at typical operating wavelength, the mode field diameter is slightly larger than the single mode fiber core diameter. So as we can see from the figure, we are having the maximum energy is given by E naught when it is varying with the radius of the fiber, that is the radius small r in micrometers, and we can see the x-axis is having the radius varying from 0 to 10 micrometers. We can see that the distribution of the energy is decreasing exponentially, and we can see that the mode field diameter is equals to twice of omega naught, which is approximately between 2 and 3. Here we can see, and this radius is omega naught, and the energy becomes E naught by E. So this figure shows the field amplitude distribution, that is E of R, of the fundamental mode in a single mode fiber, illustrating the mode field diameter, that is also abbreviated as MFD, and the spot size, which is nothing but omega naught. So in this lecture, we have discussed what is the phase velocity in optical communication, what is the group velocity in case of optical communication, and what is MFD, that is the mode field diameter, and how to calculate the spot size for a given optical wave. So thank you.